Did you realize that every time you get in your car, you have an opportunity to reduce your impact on the environment? We're gonna learn about electric vehicles. We're at Walking Mountains with Corinna and James. And guys, we're hearing more and more about these, and you guys recently had a science behind electric vehicles. The house was packed, people were curious, they were test driving cars.
Yep.
What's the big news about these?
They just make sense, you know? They're cheaper to run than a gas car. They're about 50% less expensive to run, about $1 a e-gallon, as we like to say. You know, they're getting greener as you drive them, basically, as our grid gets greener. You know, we're adding more and more renewables to our electric portfolio, as I like to call it. And, you know, your car gets powered by the sun. Our charger is fully powered by the solar panels we have on our building. And it's pretty cool. You don't ever need to go to a gas station and you can charge at home.
Well, and Corinna, you basically bought one of these cars, recently.
Yeah.
Tell us your decision-making process behind this.
Yeah, so my old gas car broke down. You know, I needed a lot of repairs that weren't going to be worth it for me, so I decided to look into a new car. With all of the awesome tax incentives that are going on right now with electric cars, it made it a pretty easy choice.
Yeah, well, definitely. And it is really interesting when you find out that these cars, they're not affected by the altitude. They have less moving parts. You have less things that go wrong with them.
You don't have to get oil changes, ever.
Nice.
Yeah.
Perfect. And how does it run? Like, what do you think? Do you notice the difference?
I mean, obviously, you know, it's going to be really quiet. Mm-hmm. As an electric car, because you don't have the engine running.
Yeah.
And they're really fast. You don't they don't switch gears, so you don't have to wait on that lag for the engine to catch up for what you're telling the car to do. It just goes.
Okay. And when people were here for the Science Behind event, what sort of questions did they have? Were there a lot of myths that you guys had?
The goal was sort of to debunk those myths. So it was kind of like, oh, it doesn't make sense in the snow, or it doesn't make sense in the mountains. You know, people ask questions as simple as, does it have a CD player? And yeah, these are normal cars. They will go anywhere you need them to go, and more are becoming available. Audi just released an all-wheel drive SUV that we could use here in the mountains that people will love. So it's getting more and more practical to have one.
Well, and you're seeing more and more charging stations all over, from Vail all the way down to Eagle in our county, but you know, elsewhere around the whole nation. Yeah. We're really seeing people shift to this. So it's pretty cool. All right. And do you like it? Do you like driving it?
I do.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really great.
It's a sweet looking car. Yeah. It's right here. All right. If we want to find out more about these, and there are a lot of incentives for us to take a look at and really save some money when we're buying our next car.
Exactly. Yeah. If anyone has any questions, they can email me at jamesd@walkingmountains.org. And I'd be happy to answer any questions about what they do, what they can do, and what our tax incentives are.
Okay. Learn more about electric vehicles by contacting Walking Mountains.